Yeah, so happy to be here. I think for us, it's, you know, working with startups is kind of like a, it's a sense of, you know, kind of duty bound, if I can say that. I think we started as a startup when virtually there wasn't any great support system existing. We'll talk about that a little more later, but, you know, as we see it, I think the kind of innovation, the kind of, you know, pushing the boundaries come, I think we pride ourselves in being, you know, one amongst that who actually did that in, you know, something which is as, let's say, structured as healthcare, right? We were the first ones to actually try and say, why can't we do it like this? So I think that has just become a kind of inherent culture. So if you look at it, there are two things in the way we work with startups. So there is obviously the clinical piece and there is the non-clinical piece. So in the clinical space, you know, we love to work with companies actually both ways, right? So there are these big behemoths which are you know, old and strong, which have their own way of bringing about innovation, but also working with startups which are young and bright and energetic. So they always start with the question why, without having to realize if there's a great market for it and all of that. And these have its own sort of benefits, disadvantages, call it what may. But I think the ability to work with some of these guys, you know, helps us also to understand how we can actually try and make about a change. And in the non-clinical piece, there is, of course, the entire thing to deal with customer engagement, right? So if you take out the clinical piece, really we are in the service of making sure that customers go back happy, right? So it's about how do you reach the extended families? How do you make sure that everyone is a big part of the process? We always go back to the fact that we are a wellness and not an illness. Pregnancy is such a wonderful period in one's life that, you know, we need to be engaging with them a whole lot meaningfully. And this is a high engagement period. So we find that people are doing things very differently, allowing new channels of engagement, allowing different ways of being able to communicate, take feedback, you know, work with customers. So this drives us entirely in a completely different direction, and you know, we just love the energy which comes out of it. As we have a very clear agenda that whatever helps us in trying to achieve a better engagement for us with our customer, we love to work with them. So for us, customers are of two kinds. There is obviously the clinicians who work with us and also the actual consumers, right? So especially with the clinicians, I think it's a little more difficult in the sense that, you know, people are used to tried and tested, and of course we're dealing with life, so obviously tried and tested has its own value. But it's also about creating the sort of an ecosystem where we are able to work with the likes of new startups who continue to push boundaries, especially in, I think, clinical and, you know, medical technologies. There are a lot of restrictions, there are a lot of rules, there are a lot of legislations as well. I think we actually want to try and work with as many as possible to make sure that, you know, these guys working within the frameworks which there are, how can we actually, you know, tend to benefit the clinicians at large, be it helping them in the way they actually manage their outcomes, be it the way they actually upgrade themselves in terms of skill sets, be it the way in, you know, how data that is generated out of some of these efforts are actually utilized for, you know, bringing it back into their practice. So it works really well. And on the consumer piece again, we want to work with anyone who's going to drive engagement for us. So this is a period again for 9 months. The beautiful 9 months are actually high engagement period. So typically what would happen is anyone who comes and helps us in terms of engaging better, engaging meaningfully, we love to work with them. So we actually started in the year 2007, you know, and in the terms of, you know, what was really a startup culture back then to what is really there today, I think it's a sea of change. Just to dial back a bit, I think people had just got off the Y2K bug and, you know, the entire dot-com bust. And so there was a lot of probably negativity around in terms of, you know, how startups are looked at. The ones who had done fairly well continued to do well. The ones who had not done well, I think, did not help, but, you know, spread the chaos that, okay, this is, you know, startups are not something which is easy to manage or easy to do, right? And we were also going to start within a very structured framework of healthcare, which, you know, has its own set of complications. So when we wanted to start about, you know, one, we did not have, I think I'm going to try and change that. I think when we started to what is here today, I think three things, access to network, access to capital, and access to information. I think these three things have changed significantly. I think 2010 onwards, a decade after Y2K, I think things started changing. Government started getting involved very recently about, you know, how they can actually encourage startups, and everybody learns, right? Usually the law is the one which is trying to play catch up with the kind of innovation which happens. So I think today you see a lot of structured framework about even, I think capital is probably the last part of the outcome, but in terms of access to network, access to information, I think that has really worked well. There are a lot of institutions which doesn't necessarily need to provide capital, but by the way of information and also access to network, I think they've been doing a wonderful job. Clearly, government plays a huge role in this, and I think from state government to central government, I think there's enough avenues for people to now try and tap into this network. So it's a wonderful time to be a startup now. Healthcare is a really tough domain, right? There's a lot of restrictions, there's a lot of legislation, it's actually a matter of life and death in most cases. So you still need to be able to drive innovation. So I think in healthcare, startups are finding two different things again. I think one in just being able to push the clinical boundaries of, you know, driving innovation of new medical technologies, assisted technologies, things which probably no consumer would directly see, but a lot of doctors would use, let's say within the confines of an operation theater and whatnot. But also assisting a lot of consumers to like engage a lot of consumers to like get reach within the, you know, medical community. I think there's a lot happening. The simple fact is, I think for healthcare startups, I think it's a much long drawn process than what most other startup industries can be. I think patience is the key, and I think longevity and sustainability is a critical element of how healthcare startups should evaluate themselves, right? If they're trying to solve a problem, you know, is this problem large enough? Is this problem sustainable enough? And eventually, I think the biggest question for most startups to understand is, who's the customer, right? Is it the customer directly? Is it hospitals? Is it clinics? Is it doctors? Is it individual practitioners? I think a lot of them do not try to bring this in the ambit of how they want to scale up. And that probably, you know, is the biggest thing that one needs to work on. Healthcare technology in India, I think, is going through that budding phase where, you know, there's a lot of meeting of minds between government pushing a lot of initiatives from the creation of India Health Stack to making sure that, you know, consumers are themselves aware of, you know, the ways and means of using technology to access basic forms of healthcare. It starts from something like simple messaging services to the most advanced of robotic surgeries that, you know, people can actually get into. So I think it's a wonderful time, but I think what is more important is, you know, India is legendary for its, you know, dismal kind of healthcare system in terms of, you know, the access to people, you know, the divide between, you know, how many doctors are available for a set of patients, the huge, you know, gap between urban and rural. So I think there is plenty of opportunity for healthcare startups to play a huge role, no matter what, no matter how good a positive intent that governments, you know, successive governments actually come in and bring about. It still requires, you know, the kind of technology push to actually be able to provide such access. So I think healthcare startups, if they are able to position themselves, build for sustainability, I think it's again a brilliant place to be. So data is a new oil, and it is with a purpose. I think, you know, data does define what you can actually do. One of the critical, most important things that us as a country needs to realize is the number of transactions in medical transactions that our country has to offer is probably the biggest world over, right? So, and, you know, we're just not doing enough to learn off each other in terms of being able to exchange some of this data. A simple initiative by the government is to create the health stack, India Health Stack, where, you know, people can start exchanging information. Obviously, all of this with privacy of the highest levels being endured, so that no individual data is actually, you know, disclosed or, you know, exploited for any nature. But the kind of outcomes that can be dealt with, the kind of data, you know, synchrony that can come in, can help in a lot of ways. I think the government has actually shown where good amount of data inclusion can help in disease management, can help in prevention of outbreaks, can help in chronic disease management can be done so much better. I think all this, you know, can be beautifully structured if everybody starts generating data in the way that is supposed to be done. Unfortunately, I think in India, you know, the carrot and stick works in very different ways. And in data, I think we're just starting to come about from legislation about how we actually start generating data to how we actually start using data. It's early days, but I think we'll get there. Again, with data, I think it's super important for everybody to realize that, you know, once applied in the right sort of spirit and know-how, you know, the bright minds at institutions like IISc can actually benefit from a lot of, you know, outcome data, and they can actually plug it back into the system to probably go back to that old saying about prevention is the best form of cure, right? So data is probably the best, data is probably the best suited to actually ensure that we get there. At Cloudnine, we're very, very strong on being able to push innovation through working with startups. We have we actually have an in-house accelerator incubator that we've set up. It's probably one of the first in the countries that hospital has taken this to actually initiate something like this. We actually encourage a whole lot of startups. We're currently working with about 25 of them actively in various domains, and we'll continue to push this number up. So for us, I think we have a very specific agenda to make sure that, you know, we're probably digital first. So this does not just mean that, you know, how consumers reach out to us, but actually how the system evolves internally. So it's a lot about how we do critical decision making. It's about how we look at, you know, what are we doing? How is it reaching the right people? What is the sort of clinical outcomes we are actually being able to drive through this? So I think we are well positioned in terms of being able to like use the help of startups, use the help of existing players, big players, small players, on how to make best use of, you know, this collaborative way of rising up together. We've actually gone through a lot of painstaking effort to actually build layers of technology within our systems. There is a core system which, you know, nobody gets involved into the production systems, which we call a system of records, which is non-interfering with this layer, which is called system of engagement. The only interaction happens through our open API layer, which we know we can then work with any kind of startup, not necessarily in India, but anywhere else, who's doing a phenomenal job of being able to work with us. It doesn't even require a physical presence of that startup to be around us, right? So we've done a whole lot of things differently, and we're very, very positive that, you know, this way.